Oh no, when you're supposed to be.
Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Okay, it is pretty quiet here at Temple tonight, but I know you can do better than that. Shabbat Shalom. Let's try there. Shabbat Shalom. How's that? Okay, there we go. Shabbat Shalom, Ethan. You know, Ethan or Hayden, just Hayden, Shabbat Shalom. Ethan reminded me it's the first Shabbat of the new year. Thank you for reminding me of that. So as we welcome Shabbat tonight, whether you're in your home or here in your spiritual home, we take a deep breath. It's been a tough week for lots of different reasons. So let's all just take one big, deep, cleansing breath. There's a little crying in the back. That's perfectly appropriate on this beginning Shabbat of the new year of 2022. And I want to share with you these words of the poet Alden Salavi in his book, This Grateful Heart, words that are called a Shabbat blessing for myself. God of rest, thank you for the week that has passed. Thank you for this Shabbat. Bless those around me with your love and your light. Let it shine on me as well. Help me to live a life of kindness and service, guided by Torah and mitzvot. Let me see others through your eyes with compassion and understanding. Let me see myself through your eyes with forgiveness and grace. May your goodness rain down upon me from this Shabbat until the next, and upon those I love, and all the days of our lives. And we say, Amen. Amen. We begin Shabbat with music, with singing. If you're at home, sing and dance. If you're here, sing and dance if you feel like it, whatever moves you. We are grateful to both Brian Lang and Jenny Snyder for music that I already know is going to be beautiful. So please join with them, with us, as we sing to welcome Shabbat.
Shabbat Shalom, everybody. We start with an igun.
It is awesome to see and hear. We have lots of kids here tonight singing and playing. Okay, I'll invite you to put your tambourines below your seat on the floor for right now. Don't worry, we'll be taking them out again. If you have your tambourines at home, you can do whatever you want. How's that? That's the beauty of Sandy Berger. You can play it as much as you want when you're at home. but while you're here, put them away until I tell you. We'll be using those later. But for now, we'd like to invite forward to lead us in the candle blessings, Miriam Grossman Rodriguez and Pedro Rodriguez. We're so honored to have both of them here to lead us in candle blessings. And at home, if you'd like to go ahead and light your own candles for yourselves and your family at home, that would be wonderful too. Page, if you're here in the sanctuary or if you have a book at home, you can turn to page 120.
As these Shabbat candles give light to all who behold them, so may we, by our lives, give light to all who behold us, as their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we, in our own day, be among those who kindle light. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lahadlik ner shel Shabbat.
Thank you to Miriam and Pedro, not only for being here to light our candles tonight, but for raising wonderful children, because I have to say this morning, I started my day along with Jenny here in the sanctuary with a classroom full of pre-K students, including their teacher, Coach Joe Rodriguez, one of the wonderful sons of Miriam and Pedro. And David, their other son, teaches here on Sundays in our JPLEX program, and we're just so honored to have you both as a part of the community. Thank you, Miriam. Thank you, Pedro. We continue our service with Lecha Dodi, page 138.
Please feel free.
Shabbat
Christ to greet the Shabbos bride. Mo'i v'shalom ateret ala gam simcha.
Remain standing for the Chatzi Kaddish, page 263.
Yitkadav, yitkara shmei rabba. Amen. Be'amad ivrahi rutei v'yamnich mahotei. Be'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'haye rachol bit Yisrael. Amen.
Continue with the Baruchu.
We're going to do an up-tempo one tonight. Here we go. Becomes day and day turns.
seated as we continue with the Ve'ahavta, page 268. Please join me. Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha v'hayu hadavarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha hayom al levavecha v'shinantam levanecha v'divarta ha'pam v'shivtecha v'veitecha u'v'lektecha v'aderech u'v'shochbecha u'kumecha u'kshartam le'ot ayadecha v'ayu l'totafot v'inenecha u'ktavtam al mezuzopetecha u'visharecha Leman tizkeru va'asitem et kol mitzvotai v'item kedoshim l'Eloheichem. Ani Adonai Eloheichem asher hotzeiti echem me'eretz Mitzrayim li'od lachem l'Elohim. Ani Adonai Eloheichem. We are about to sing the song of praise that our people sang when they crossed out of Egypt and went towards freedom. And we're in the part of the Torah that is leading up to this incredible moment, this moment of celebration. And as we get to that moment, we also think about our own freedom, the freedoms we celebrate, which are not freedoms in the Torah. It's not just freedom to do anything we want. It's freedom to follow the commandment. It's really, it's freedom to that leads to a life of Torah, a life of mitzvot that brings so much meaning to our lives. And so as we celebrate that freedom, we think about what it means for us as Jews to celebrate a freedom that also is paired with a life of meaning. So we sing not only with just reckless abandon in terms of the kind of freedom we have, but also a meaningful one. So join with us as we sing. You can take out your tambourines because there is celebrating, there is dancing. I feel sure there will be dancing. And you can even dance here in the sanctuary tonight. It's a little bit small around here. We have just the few, the strong, the proud here in the synagogue tonight. So if you guys want to get up and dance, you can. And at home, of course, you're always welcome to. Micha Mocha, please join us. Page 270.
And truth be told, I was going to do a slow Micha Mocha, but because there are so many amazing tambourine players, tambourinists. Is that a thing?
Tambourinists.
In the congregation tonight, I think we need to do something fast.
They're trained tambourinists, don't worry.
I know, because I taught them all in the Margot School. I see you.
Tambourine playing. I can tell they learned from you, Jenny. I can tell they trained for that for many, many years. And for all of those of you at home, I can see you dancing and singing, and we love to see that. We love that you're so engaged, even from home. We're thrilled you're with us. We move into the next prayer, the Hashkivenu. And this prayer asks that God protect us at night. Now, I don't know about you, but many people I know, including myself, have had a little bit of trouble, sometimes a lot of trouble, sleeping at night. And this prayer is just the one for you for that moment. It asks that God protect us while we sleep, give us rest, give us that ability to be so carefree that we can rest. so that we can wake up knowing that we will be okay and safe, our children, our loved ones, and that we pray the world will be okay, safe, and a place where we can go to sleep, rest, and wake up renewed. We say at the bottom of page 271, Baruch Ata Adonai HaPorei Sukkot Shalom, Aleinu V'Yokol Amo Yisrael Ve'al Yerushalayim. And we continue our prayers with Vishamru, page 272. Together, all of that ruach, all of that spirit, both here in our sanctuary and wherever you are that you're logging in and watching and praying with us tonight as Shabbat enters, we join together in our Amidah on page 273. If you're able, please rise.
Adonai Sefatai Tiftacho Fiyagite Hirata. Tenue
Please be seated. Join me on page 278. Together. May these hours of rest and renewal open our hearts to joy and our minds to truth. May all who struggle find rest on this day. May all who suffer find solace. May all who hurt find healing on this day. May all who despair find purpose. May all who hunger find fulfillment on this day. And may we all live in such a way that this day fulfill its promise. Baruch atah Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat. We come to the prayer for Thanksgiving. And this morning with our Margot School students, I asked them what they're thankful for, and they had a lot to say. So I'd love for you to turn to somebody near you or just think of it yourself. What is it that you are thankful for on this day? If you want, if you're online, you can put it in the chat. I'm not gonna come around, but if you're near someone, you can tell them, or like I said, keep it to yourself and tell yourself. What are you thankful for today on this Shabbat? I am thankful for life, for health, for family and friends, for community. There's so many blessings that we pass by every day and don't acknowledge, but Shabbat gives us that opportunity to think about and acknowledge each blessing, each prayer, each gift in our lives. We think of all of those blessings on this Shabbat, and we say thank you to God for each one of them. We say, O God, our Redeemer and Helper, let all who live affirm you and praise your name in truth. Blessed are you, Adonai, your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving. Baruch atah Adonai hatov shimcha, ulecha na'ed lehodot. And we pray for the greatest gift, the gift of peace, not only for us and our loved ones and our families and our homes and our neighborhoods and our communities, in our nation. May it be a nation of peace in our homeland of Israel, in all of the world. We pray that we will bring about a time of peace with Shalom Rav.
Shalom Rav, Yisrael Amcha, Be'akol Yoshei Teimeh. Shalom Rav, Yisrael Amcha, Ta'asim Le'yo.
Before we go on, I want to share some of the thoughts that are in the chat, just in case you didn't see them, of things that people are thankful for in our community. They're so good. Jake Labby says he's in his first regular Hillel Judaic Studies class. I love that. And thankful for regular school mainstream Hillel First Judaic Studies class. That's awesome, Jake. And Susie Mazel Tov, a beautiful wedding ceremony last Thursday performed by Rabbi Fish. Mazel Tov to the family. That was for, that must be for Sandy's grandson, Jonathan Berger, to his bride, Isabel Morris. Marcia says for our health, and Fallon and Ryla Dennison say for school and family, and especially my sister, Ryla. I love that. That was really good. We have so many things to be thankful for. And as I mentioned, it has been a very difficult week. In fact, I've had to tell numerous people to turn the news off this week. It's just too much at a certain point. Because as you know, 1 year ago yesterday, our democracy was under attack. And so this is a prayer from our Siddur. It's in our Mishkan Tefillah. It's a prayer for our country. It's a prayer for healing. It's a prayer for peace. O guardian of life and liberty, may our nation always merit your protection. Teach us to give thanks for what we have by sharing it with those who are in need. Keep our eyes open to the wonders of creation and alert to the care of the earth. May we never be lazy in the work of peace. May we honor those who have died in defense of our ideals. Grant our leaders wisdom and forbearance. May they govern with justice and compassion. Help us all to appreciate one another and to respect the many ways that we may serve you. May our homes be safe from affliction and strife, and our country be sound in body and spirit. And we all say, Amen. We take time now for our silent, or let's say quiet, prayers for a few moments here in the sanctuary. We pray silently. in the last week, almost everyone that I've spoken with, and I've spoken with a lot of people, was somehow touched by illness, mostly Omicron, COVID, but almost every single person had some kind of illness going on in their family or household. And so we pray for each one, each and every one of our loved ones, of our community members, of those we know, that they may find strength and health and hope and move forward. We especially think of these loved ones at this time: Mary Arnold, Hope, Ellen Keller, Yifat Bayoram, Judy Brown, Darren Williams, Mauricio Lara, Sharon and Paul Weiner, Bennett Greenberg, Ronald Horwich, Alice Horwich, Isabella De La Husse, Marnie Gitlitz, Sarah Batsall, Natalie Keegan, Edwina Cherubin, Roberto Lowenstein, Marvin Gilman, Dorita Levenstein, Yoli Marlowe, Mariana Green, Greg Miller, Batya Bat Menachem Mendel, Stephen Carlin, Jessica Hunter, Peter Stein, Alicia, Aliza Pelia Bat Avraham Visara, Yale David, Marsha Kropf, Karina Casanas, Brenda Tucci, Carol Shulkin, Steve Hertz, Shirley Harris, Kelly Henley, Rini Feingold, Mark Kaplan, Steve Winkler, Diane Arnkoff, Ilana Miriam Bathava, Martha Friedman, Joe Botkin, Ivy Bolenstein, Ava Wilson, Jenny Wasserstrom, Jeff Clark, Noah Schwartz, Sandy Kramer, Vivian Witkoff, Dana Pelletier, Michal Batsara, Gloria Fig, Vittel Bat Ruth, Valentina Letichevsky, Nancy Pastroff, Kyle Gittleman, Josh Rosen, Erwin Fetter, Sonia Greenberg, Hazel Bernstein, Elaine Ben David, Maria Jimeno, Eileen Dan Heiser, Jesse Friedman, Josh Snyder, Bella Lopez, Herbert Mercado, Patty Campo, Heschel Ben Mindel, Orlando Catano, Howard Israel, Ellen Leesfield, Hilda Kane, Malkabat Esther, Diana Maria Lane, Ross Lipton, Alan Trupkin, Michael Lebb, Dr. Bob Atlas, Phyllis Ehrlich, and all of those you were thinking of. You're welcome to stand in the sanctuary and say the names. We're not going to come around tonight, but if you will, say the names of those you're thinking of. If you're online, say the names aloud or put them in the chat. Please say the names of those loved ones you're thinking of.
Ulysses Maciel.
And all of those who are battling illness of body, mind, and spirit, and all of the caregivers, all of those who are in recovery, we pray for each one with the words of the Mishaberach together.
We don't have these words in our Siddur, but it is a call and response song, so I'll say the English words, and if you choose, you can repeat after me.
If I
Adonai Rofe HaCholim, and we all say with prayers for health and healing in our hearts. Amen.
We have, you couldn't see it on Zoom, and maybe only Rabbi Siegel, myself, maybe Miss Jenny and Brian saw it, but there was some head banging going on during services. I have never seen that before, but it looks like chuckling, but in a more intense way. So I see it. And I love your enthusiasm. Count with me. Ready? Dam, Tzefardea, Kinim, Arov, Dever, Shechim, Barad, Arbe, Choshech, Makat Bechorot. We all know the litany of our Seder's 10 plagues, starting with blood, and ending in the death of the firstborn. Let me focus this evening on what I believe to be our most challenging plague. Darkness. We have lost the ability to see each other. I recently read in a story of a rabbi who was deeply engrossed in her own studies late at night. When the rabbi's youngest child, fell out of her cradle. Even though the rabbi was only in the next room, she heard nothing. The rabbi's mother was also studying in her room upstairs. Nevertheless, she heard the baby and went downstairs to calm her. Afterwards, she reprimanded her own daughter, who had remained oblivious throughout. How could you leave the baby crying? The daughter replied that she had not even heard the baby's tears. The rabbi had what she thought was a legitimate excuse, explaining to her mother that she simply hadn't heard. She had been so engrossed in her studies that she was oblivious to everything else. The excuse did not wash. You should never be so involved in your own spiritual endeavors that you fail to hear the cry of a child, the mother told her daughter, the rabbi. The greatest darkness is when a person sees not their fellow. And this most definitely applies today. Are we so self-centered to care about others? Do we get lost in our own truth and ignore the other person who might think differently than we do? Are we all lost in the plague of darkness, unable to see outside of our bubble, our own existence? Is there not room to see, hear, listen, adjust, maybe grow, admit when we're wrong, and forgive when others are lost? I'm afraid to admit it, but yes, we are in a moment of darkness. Our Sidra Parshat Bo details the intensity of this choshech, this darkness. There was a thick darkness over the entire land of Egypt for 3 days. One Egyptian did not see his brother, and no one rose from his place for 3 days. But all the Israelites had light in their dwellings. Exodus chapter 10, verse 22 to 23. Like all the others before, this plague did not affect the lives of B'nai Israel. No. They had light. They could see one another. They could see the thick darkness that existed. They knew that God was with them in that still, small flame or that glimmer of comfort. For the Israelites, their flame was more than just a way to walk about and see or be seen. What they had was hope, motivation, a desire to make better for the next generation of Israelites. But on the other hand, the Egyptians had despair, depression, and inability to see the wrongs and make right in their own world. We too are suffering as they did, but we don't have to. Our current plague of darkness is raging, and it looks a lot like people ignoring others. People only caring about one side of a difficult topic. It looks like people assuming one thing based off of where you are from, or what sign you once had in your yard, or even the car you drive. We have stopped seeing people for who they are. What is the solution? We need more light. To understand why the Israelites weren't affected by the darkness, we seek out the wisdom from the book of Proverbs. It says, chapter 6, verse 23, a mitzvah is a candle, and Torah is the light. Within each of us, the eternal flame. But what is that eternal flame? It's a gift from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Holy One of Blessing. How sad that we've been given a gift, but not the ability to use it. It's time that we use and share this gift of ours. The gift is an Or LeGoyim, being a light unto the nations, a light to the American conversation, a light to our community, maybe to our neighbors. We need that light within our own homes. The light exists, and it is shown to the world by what we do, what we say, how we treat the other. It's within the organizations we support, if we support organizations. The money we send to sustain others, it's actually our attitude, the way we move about this world, the way we carry ourselves. Not just within our homes, but outside as we navigate this choshech, the darkness. Last week, I entered into a gas station, running between meetings and a funeral, to grab some propane. I wanted to cook some burgers. Now, the woman behind the counter, with her mask like a Floridian around her chin, didn't smile, didn't greet me, didn't care that I was there. So in my head, I said, challenge accepted. I'm going to turn this situation around. I greeted her saying, hi, good morning. I'm so sorry to trouble you, but I'm a guy in need of gas. Whenever you are free, could you help me out? Her body shifted. Her mood shifted. And my candle lit hers, but just a little bit. My flame touched her wick and produced more light, but just a little bit. She said, sweetie, I don't think we have much gas left. I responded, it's all good. But if you do, I'd be so grateful. In fact, it would make my New Year's so hot, so cheeky. She stepped outside the convenience store, and sure enough, there were four canisters, and I needed two. Dressed in a suit with my bow tie, I said, don't worry, I can take them and replace my old ones. You don't have to lift a thing. I thanked her and said how much I appreciated her help. I paid, thanked her again, and left. As I was leaving, she said, and I quote, have a good day, Jonah. I said, thank you. Jonah. Got it. She took the time to read my name on my credit card. Because of my last name, and it is quite long, thank you, Mom, you're watching, they can only fit J-O-N-A. And she called me by my name. Under my mask, I smiled. I felt her light. She radiated off of me. I did nothing heroic. I didn't stop hunger. I didn't talk down a person with hatred. I just spread that which was this gift. A little bit of lightness, a little bit of humor, and some real politeness. And she got it. And I got it. And we now have each other's light. Hillel says, be among the disciples of Aaron, loving peace, pursuing peace, loving people, and bringing them closer to Torah. This is how we spread light, Torah. It's not just a book, but it's a lifestyle. It's how we care. It's how we listen. It's how we argue for the sake of heaven. It's how we forgive, how we honor one another, even those who are far different than ourselves. To shed our darkness, to rid ourselves of this plague, share more of your light. We must be in Or LeGoyim as a nation, as a people, as a Temple Judea community. Darkness cannot exist in an abundance of light, so let's light up our world, bringing more hope and peace, thoughtfulness and inspiration to others. It's time to rid our world of the darkness, one person at a time, one spark transferring to another soul, to rid the thickness of Choshech from our world and our reality. Shabbat Shalom. I have the unique pleasure of inviting up Miriam Rodriguez Grossman Rodriguez. Excuse me, you also have a long last name with a hyphen. Us hyphen people gotta stick together. To share some words of announcements. Thank you so much, Miriam.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. I am Miriam Grossman Rodriguez, the treasurer of Temple Judea, and I want to thank my husband, Pedro, for lighting the Shabbat candles with me, and he's also going to join me doing the Kiddush and Motzi blessings tonight. Join us tomorrow with our minyan service at 9 a.m., followed by Torah study at 10 a.m. These services will be available on Zoom only. Be sure to read your weekly e-blast or visit our website for the Zoom links. We look forward to seeing you on Zoom. Shabbat Shalom.
When I was a boy growing up at the synagogue, I had the joy of attending services every single Friday. I think my dad was temple president, and he brought me along, and I got to sit on the bima. I don't know how I sat still. I was probably 5 or 8 years old, and it was always a highlight because the rabbi of the community, Rabbi Burke, would allow all the kids to come up and open the ark for the Aleinu. And then there was a woman in the community, we called her Grandma Lil, and she would give us Bubblicious gum afterwards. And for maybe a four-year-old, my numbers keep going down, chewing a stick of gum this big, what made Shabbat so sweet. I don't have gum, but I do see some incredible young children here who I would love to invite up with their families. So I would love to have Ethan and Hayden, Nathan and JJ, and your parents, the Lagos and the Juriestas, to come forward and help us open the ark. In full transparency, I have no treats, but opening the Lagos are like, I'm out.
They know where the candy is.
Yeah, we're going to hook you up later. Rabbi Siegel's got a good stash. Please rise as we turn to page 586 for the words of the Aleinu.
Later.
Please be seated. JJ, you did a beautiful job as you opened the ark and kept your hand over your heart the whole time of the Aleinu. I'm going to add that to my minhag for Aleinu now. Open the ark, feel my heart as if I'm standing at attention of the flag, the holy flag of our people, the Torah. Beautiful, beautiful, bro, buddy. Wow. We transition within our service as we remember our loved ones who walked, who lived, who smiled, but sadly are no longer with us. Sometimes we understand when it's time for someone to go, and sometimes we don't. But each one is still painful as we reflect and we remember. And especially on this Shabbat, remember the yard sites of Pauline Abelson, Evelyn Blackman, Gertrude Fink, Anna Frogel, Hyman Gross, Anna Gross, Florence Grossman, Sarah Roth Jacobson, Lena Kaplan, Esther Kaufman, Florence Kaufman, Martha C. Klein, Isidore Kornblum, Sophia Lambert, Mark Lemkin, Anita Magidson, Ruth Frogel Mansdorf, Jack Phillips, Henry Rakowski, Randy Robbins, Jean Rubin, Dr. Robert Salzman, Shirley Saul, Irving Schreiber, Saul Schreiber, Rose Shapiro, Tracy Shapiro, Lillian Stoller, Esther Volgen, Eva Wayne, Sylvia Yespi, and Abraham Zarkin. Remember those who have passed away within this year. Esther Botlea, Sandy Fisher, Anthony Carmona, Carol Horowitz, Stephen Indiana, Francis Kolarak, Clifford M. Stein, Michael Pearl, Michael Tobin, Justice Gerald Kogan, Rabbi Solomon Schiff, Morris Levitt, Edward Lassoff, Thelma Stein, Evan Reed, Barry Hesser, Fred Diamond, Faye Pushkin Aronson, Vivian Machaber, Pearl Wald, Robert Siegel, Dr. Stanley Jacobs, Joan Rubenstein, Rosalind Winter, Murray Diamond, Fred Chekanow, David Dollinger, Robert Joseph Mezzi, Sue Katz, Natalie Ginsburg, Michael Stokes, Dr. Will Blackman, Marsha Coven, Sheila Resnick, Susan Crow, Mimi Weinfeld, Fern Wayne, Stan Sterling, Shani Levin, and this week we add the name of Carol Ellis Shapiro. If you are in the first week of losing a loved one, please rise. If it's within the first month of someone that you're remembering, please rise. If it's within the year, Shana, of losing a member of your family, please rise. And if this Shabbat marks the yard site of someone close to you, please stand. We stand as a kehillah, as a holy community. We stand for all those who passed away who died, whose lives were taken in the Shoah. We stand as we honor our American soldiers as well as our brothers and sisters in Israel who fought and lost their lives defending this country and Eretz Yisrael, as we turn to page 598 and say these words of Kaddish Yatom, the Mourner's Kaddish. Yitkadal v'yitkadash shemei rabba be'ama divrach rute ve'almich malchute b'chayachon uv'yomechon uv'chayei dechol beit Yisrael ba'agala uv'izman kariv ve'imru. Amen.
Yehe Shmei Rabba Mevarach Leolam Leolam Amaya Yidbarach Vishdabach Vitpa'ar Vitromam Vitnase Vitadar Vitale Vitalal Shmei Dekudusha Berichu Leolam Minko Birchata Vashirata Tushbechata Venechemata Da'amiran Be'ama Ve'imru Amen Yehe Shlama Rabba Min Shemaya Vechayim Aleinu Be'akol Yisrael Ve'imru Amen O Se Shalom Bimromav Hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu ve'akol Yisrael, ve'imru. Amen. We have a job as B'nai Yisrael, and it's spelled out very clearly, to be an Or L'Goyim, to be a light to each other, to our family members, our community, our country, and to all nations in the world. That's a gift. The gift is the ability to spread that light. Take an opportunity this Shabbat to think about how you can be that special soulful light, that Or, and how you can spread it to the world around you. Ken Yehi Ratzon, may it be God's will that we all live up to the trueness of that gift, of that Or, that light. And may we all have the ability to spread it, as we all say, Amen. Our closing song is none other than Hallelujah. No.
I changed my mind. I liked your message so much that I thought we would do mitzvah goreret mitzvah, which is all about one good deed leading to another.
And I was going to say that. Our closing song is mitzvah goreret mitzvah.
That's right. It's on page 646 if you want to follow along. Here we go. Mitzvah goreret mitzvah.
I didn't either, but it's great, Miles. Shabbat Shalom. I'd like to invite up Pedro and Miriam to lead us in our Kiddush and Hamotzi. We're still doing that special thing at Temple Judea where you get to walk out with Kiddush and Motzi, with grape juice and challah when you leave. Let me get you a microphone.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Parei HaGafen
Amen.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kiddushanu B'mitzvotav V'ratzavanu V'Shabbat Kodesho Be'ahava U'Ratzon Hinhilanu Zikaron L'Maaseh Bereishit Kihu yom tehila le mikra e kodesh, zecher tziyah.
Baruch atah Adonai
Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz.
Amen. Shabbat shalom.
Shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. No, it's 100%. It's the Floridian way.